You are watching BPDTV.
Good afternoon and welcome to BPDTV. I'm your host, Sergeant Anthony Smith, and this is your daily update for January 8th, 2013. Yesterday, BPDTV reported the tragic death of 7-month-old Kendall Brown in the 5600 block of Sagar Road in Northeast. Well, yesterday, homicide detectives arrested and charged 29-year-old Francois Brown, the father of the child. In other news, last night, just before 11 p.m., police were dispatched to the 7-Eleven store located in the 5200 block of North Charles Street for a reported commercial robbery. Police met with employees who advised a male just came into the store and robbed them of money and cigarettes. A description of the suspect was broadcasted to backup officers who were quickly able to locate a male fitting the suspect description. He was found in the 100 block of West Fayette Street. The suspect was identified as 41-year-old Linnies Jackson. Detective Jeremy Silbert was on scene last night.
So it's Monday night, right around 9 p.m. Tell us what happened in the Central District.
We received a call for a commercial robbery at 7-Eleven, 529 North Charles, with a suspect with a brown coat, black sweatpants with a white stripe on it, number one male. Officer Saab and other officers stopped same at Fayette and Liberty. Recovered the money, property, cigarettes, and see why robbery's going to take control of it.
And we had the store clerk was able to come down
and possibly ID them with the property and everything. So.
Mr. Jackson had been previously arrested in 2010 for allegedly robbing the same exact store. This was excellent work by the officers who responded to the scene, and they quickly located Mr. Jackson, as well as the detectives who are investigating this robbery. Jackson faces numerous charges, including robbery, assault, and theft. Commissioner Batts has made it clear that one of his top priorities as police commissioner is community engagement. Well, Detective Jeremy Silbert was hard at work last night. In addition to going to the scene of a robbery, he was also in the Southeast District for a community meeting, and we now have a short video to show you.
Last night, officers from the Southeast District joined members of the community for the Southeast District's Community Relations Council meeting. Once a month, members of the community gather at the Southeast District and meet with police officers. Major Bill Davis, the commanding officer of the Southeast District, was also in attendance. During the meeting, Major Davis introduced the new captain of the Southeast District, Captain Burris. Major Melissa Hyatt, who is the former captain of the Southeast District, was also in attendance and received thanks and awards from members of the community for her service to the Southeast District over the years. Major Davis also introduced the Southeast District's Officer of the Month, Police Officer Henson of the Flex Squad. And finally, Director Anthony Guglielmi from the Public Affairs Section spoke to members of the community. Director Guglielmi discussed social media and other ways that the police department communicates with the public. Also in attendance at the meeting were other members from city government, including the health department and city council.
And finally, if you want to become a member of the Baltimore Police Department, we're looking for qualified men and women to join our ranks. Come to police headquarters tonight at 6 p.m. and you can take the civil service test, the first step in the hiring process. Go to bpdrecruit.com for more information. Remember to follow the Baltimore Police Department on Twitter, keyword Baltimore Police, for news and updates. Watch BPDTV every day on our website, baltimorepolice.org, or you can watch every night at 9 p.m. on TV25, Baltimore's cable channel. For BPDTV, I'm Anthony Smith. Have a great day, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.